What's up guys, my name is Pritesh and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I'll be teaching you how to play cinematic fonts on a film. We'll first begin with a free stock footage. I personally use vimeo.com to find most of my stock footages. I'll try to find the best footage possible and I search for a 4K free stock footage here. And let's wait till the results appear. So there it goes. I think this one looks nice to me. It says time-lapse mountains 4K resolution. We'll go ahead and check whether the footage is up to the mark. It says it's been shot on a Red Epic at 5K resolution. That's incredible. I'll just go ahead and play a few seconds of the clip to assure the quality of the film and to really know whether that's something I really need. It's looking promising to me. I'll now copy the link from Vimeo and try to download this video. I personally use clipconverter.cc to download most of my videos online. It's a much easier to use interface. I'll choose 4K resolution here and click on MP4. That's the format I want. It'll first begin with the conversion and you would have the download link in a few seconds. So you just hit the download button and your video begins to download. It'll take a while. Meanwhile, let's just check a few fonts online. I use dafont.com to download most of my fonts. It's an amazing free resource with lots of themes, like you can see, plenty of options available and easy to install fonts. So we begin with our next step. Let's just open Premiere Pro. I'll begin with a new project, name the file, and let's go ahead. Okay, so I'll choose the downloaded file from the download folder and we have it on our timeline. I then go to sequence settings. As you can see, I have 1920 by 1080 pixels, which is the HD size. I then scale my clip to my frame size. And then I go to title window, a new title, a default still. I name it title 01 and hit the OK button. I'll just write some random text. I write best cinematic fonts and how to place them on a video. It's pretty much easy. I centerline them to the page. And I always think if you make all of these lines an independent text, it's pretty convenient for you to resize them and handle with much more ease. So I just go ahead and separate all of the three lines. That's something I do with most of my titles. See, a difference in size and the orientation is something which works most of the times. So I have now all of the things to the center of the page. This is how it looks, pretty neat and clean. I choose my font style for my separate lines to keep them, you know, to keep them classy. And we repeat the whole thing again, bring it to the center of the page. I close the title bar now and place the text over the film and let's see how it looks like. Okay, this looks nice to me. And in case you want to add few more titles in future, you can simply duplicate the file and click the name of your choice. I now give the name I felt suits the film. Let's name this The Himalayan Diaries. So it's pretty much the same and this is how it looks. I have now that on the video and there it goes. So it gives a classy look to your video. So I have my video now complete in place. I'll just save the project and try to export this file. Let's go to export media. I have H.264 HD 1080 pixels, 25 frames per second. And this is the final version, how it is going to look like. Enjoy, guys.
What you say tells me nothing. What's the truth? Give me something. Take me down a road I believe in. Lost the way, lost all reason.